Hey, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of JM's Rock Talk. I'm Mark, and this is my brother, Jim. We're here tonight to discuss or watch and react to a brand new, maybe not so brand new, but a band that we've never had any experience with, never heard, just kind of came up for us tonight. So we're going to give it a shot. The band is Mammoth WVH, meaning this is Eddie Van Halen's son, Wolfgang's band. And we're going to listen to a song by, it's called I'm Alright. Again, no idea what this song sounds like. I'm assuming this is going to be kind of a hard rocking song, in the style of Van Halen. Maybe I really don't know. Yeah. I'm actually looking forward to it, to be quite honest with you, having listened to Wolfgang when he first played bass, you know, with Van Halen. We'll see how it goes. I'm kind of excited. And then, at the end of the whole thing, we'll kind of get back together here, I guess, and give a little talk about what we've witnessed here. So without further ado, I guess, let's give it a shot. Not a bad intro so far.
Yeah. All right. Wow. What'd you think?
That was something different.
Yeah.
Well, let's see. What was your reaction? Let's go with you first.
I mean, it wasn't a complex song, but it was, I liked the, I definitely liked the feel of it.
It was a very driving,
hard-edged
song.
One of the things that I was running through my head near the end was, rock, like guitar rock is still alive. And, it may not, although I did see a statistic earlier today that rock music is on the rise again in terms of popularity through the course of 2023. There were more downloads for rock.
What is it edging out?
I forget. I just saw that it was definitely moving up and in terms of popularity. And so I can see where Wolfgang definitely got influences from his dad and from Van Halen, but he has his own sound. He has his own style. And I think,
There is that there's that very heavy sound that I think they were trying to achieve that Van Halen certainly had in live performances. It was, power, 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 power. I think he's a little more raw, I think.
Yeah.
That is Wolfgang. He's a lot more raw. The band is a lot more raw. I don't think they're as refined as
well-toured
and well-rehearsed.
Yeah, and you were talking about power chords. I think this is more of a power chord-driven kind of band, whereas Van Halen certainly had their power chords, but there was a transparency in Van Halen's style. Particularly in the early days.
Sound that was all so unique and new.
Yeah.
You remember that when you first heard Diver Down, do you remember that? I know Fair Warning ahead of that, but when I first heard Diver Down, like that sound was so purely like Van Halen. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. So this is not, maybe these sounds are not as original, but, it definitely grabs your attention and I liked it. I would listen to more.
I was on the fence with this. I think part of it for me was maybe it's just the video you chose, but or whatever, the sound quality just wasn't as good. I mean, the vocals, you couldn't hear them. Certainly the sound engineering needs to be dealt with a lot. I think I'm just trying to, I am being a devil's advocate. I'm just pointing out what I think is the obvious here, I guess, but I think that makes a big difference for me, how it comes across and how I hear it. I'm all in favor of power bands. Power chords don't bother me at all. Being of the generation of growing up with power chords, with any band really. But despite all that, I think Wolfgang is demonstrating that he does know how to play.
Oh, yeah.
Obviously, he's very versatile. He can play the guitar. He can play the bass. So, he had one of the best teachers on the planet. So I hope that with that, all this criticism I'm giving on the good side of all this is I just love listening to Wolfgang. I've heard him in some interviews and he's just a great personable guy. I think he's just a fun guy to hang out with probably too, and I'm not dissing him in any way. He's got his definitely, like you said, he's got his own style. I think I need to hear more to be really fair. But on this first reaction, I'm not overly impressed. I'm slightly underwhelmed by it, but I think with some time, and like I said, better sound quality, better engineering, I think coming through, I might have a different approach to that. So that's my honest take on it.
Yep. All right. Well that's, there you have it. I'd be curious to see what other people think of our reaction. And by the way, I mean, we're in our 50s. We grew up on classic rock and this is a new thing for us to react to things that are out there now. And it's stretching the ears and stretching our
but I think we have a good repertoire, a good palette of musical background that we can draw from.
Oh, for sure, for sure. For sure.
At any time you have any kind of critique or criticism, I think it should be paired with positive and constructive. I think that's what we tried to do here today. So, we'll do more of this coming down the road as well.
Yeah, we've got some other things in mind, and we'll see about getting those programmed.
Yeah, absolutely. All right. So with that in mind, this was a fun episode. Again, the band was Mammoth, WVH. That's Wolfgang Van Halen, and the song was "I'm All Right." Check it out. Make a like in the little section that you ring a bell and like and comment on this particular one. And yeah, we're always interested to see what you have to say. So stay tuned for the next one, everybody. I hope you had fun with this one. We certainly did. This is Mark, my brother Jim. We're Jams Rock Talk. We'll see you in the next episode. Have a good one, everyone.